Good morning, children. I hope you are all doing good by the grace of God. Today, I am going to tell you a story about a father and his two sons. The elder son was a very obedient boy. But the younger son, he had lot of bad friends. And, he always enjoyed being in the company of his bad friends. You know, bad friends teach you to do bad things. They teach you to go in the wrong way. And they destroy your life. No, so many precious lives have been destroyed because of bad friends. You must be very careful as to what kind of friends you make. How do you know whether they are good friends or bad friends? Good friends will teach you good things, but whereas bad friends will teach you bad things. Now, this boy wanted to enjoy all the time with his friends, and his friends taught him, told him, why not we go to a faraway country and enjoy our lives and have fun. So this boy went to his father and said, Father, you divide the property and give me my share. I want to go to a faraway country with my friends. The father refused. He said, no, my son, it is very bad for you. But the son kept on asking him, day in and day out, he was forcing his father. So the father got vexed finally, and he decided to divide the property and gave the younger son his share. The younger son went away with his friends, very happily. Jolly jolly makes you gali gali. So this they all had fun. Of course, they had real fun. They did. They enjoyed themselves in all sinful pleasures. But then slowly the money started decreasing. After few months, the friends realized that the younger son had less money. So one by one, the friends left him. Finally, all his friends had left him, and he had no money. So he decided to look for a job, and you know what? He managed to get a job of of rearing pigs, of taking care of pigs. He was so hungry, and he did not get enough food. So he even thought of eating the pig's food, it seems. At that time, he remembered how the servants in his father's house were treated. Even the servants got very good food, and they lived very well. Their condition was good, but now here his condition was so bad. So he thought, why, let me go back to my father's house and ask my father for forgiveness, and then let me ask my father to make me his servant. I cannot ask him to make me his son again, but let me beg him to make me his servant. So he went back to his father's house. The father saw this younger son walking towards the house. So he went running, it seems, and hugged the boy, and with eyes full of tears, he kissed him. He was so happy to see his son. Then the son said, sorry father, sorry daddy, I did so much of harm to you. I have destroyed all your wealth. But then let me become your servant. Now I wish to become your servant. But then the father said, no, don't forget about it. I'm so happy to see you. And so he took him back, and then there was a big celebration, it seems. See, father's love is unconditional. Unconditional means mother and father, they don't expect anything from you. When they love you, they don't expect anything in return from you. But others are not like that. So you must give first priority to your parents' love. And above all, God's love is the most supreme kind of love, because God says, I will carry you like a father, like how a father carries his child. You know, when you were small, your fathers used to carry you in different ways, right? Likewise, God will carry you, it seems, till the end of your life. He is ready to carry you. So, first love is God's love. Second love is your parents' love, your brother, sister's love. You must give importance to this love. And then only your friends and other relatives and so on and so forth. And you must be very careful as to what kind of friends you choose. Bad friends will teach you only bad things. Good friends will teach you good things. So, you must make only good friends. With this in mind, shall we bow down our heads and pray? Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. God bless you all, children. Take care.
Hi students, I hope you are safe at home. Today we are going to learn English lesson number 2, titled Trip to Ooty. Ooty is fondly known as Queen of Hills. The road leading to town is full of hairpin bends. Hairpin bends means Kondu Oosi Valaivu. The other name for Ooty is Udagamandalam. When we think of Ooty, the first thing that comes to our mind is climatic condition, which is suitable for summer vacation. The most attracting places in Ooty are Ooty Lake, Botanical Garden, Emerald Lake, Kamrad Sagar Dam, St. Stephen's Church, etc. Let us move into the lesson. So, Ooty, we can see the picture of Ooty here. Ooty is fondly known as Queen of Hills. Let us see the explanation for section 1. In this section, it deals about with the letter written by Merlin to Mali. Merlin shares her experience about her trip to Ooty with her friends through the letter. Her class teacher, Mrs. Geeta, and other two teachers accompanied. Accompanied means to go somewhere with someone. A group of 20 girls and boys from class 6. Merlin had heard from her grandmother about the beautiful journey to Ooty by the toy train. But this is the first time she experienced a trip to Ooty with her classmates and friends. She said that it was a spectacular trip. Spectacular means eye-catching. Up and down the slopes with birds and trees dancing along the way. Students, do you know where is Ooty located? Ooty is close to Coimbatore. The other name for Ooty is Udagamandalam, a hill station area. Merlin wrote that she was so excited when she stepped into the toy train with her friends. Inside the train, they were wooden chairs with cushioned seats and oil painted walls. This toy train has two engines with limited compartments, and the engine moves with the help of coal. Coal means nilakari. Merlin and her classmates were enjoying the view from the toy train. We can see the picture of the toy train here. Her teacher, Mrs. Geeta, came around to see that everyone was seated properly. The train started with a jerk. Jerk means a sudden sharp movement, and moved slowly, leaving the station with a long hoot. Hoot means the sound of a horn. Everyone clapped joyfully. The train went snaking up. Snaking means moving like a snake. Up the steep hillside, leaving its way through forest of all trees, swaying in the breeze. Swaying means moving slowly or rhythmically. One of the boys named Muthu said he wanted to move along the train as it was moving slowly. On the other hand, the teacher noticed his movement and said in a harsh voice to move back to his seat. The girl sniggered. Sniggered means laughed in a half suppressed way. And Muthu went back to his seat with a long face. Long face means with an unhappy face. Okay students, let us see the question part for the section 1. First one, where did the boys and girls go? The boys and girls of class 6 went on a trip to Ooty. I repeat the answer again. The boys and girls of class 6 went on a trip to Ooty. Second one, why did Muthu say that he could walk along its sides? Answer, Muthu said that he could walk along its sides because the train was moving very slowly. I repeat the answer again. Muthu said that he could walk along its side because the train was moving very slowly. Third question, why did the girl snigger? Snigger means what? Laughed in a half suppressed way. Their answer is, the girl sniggered because the teacher shouted at Muthu to go back to his seat immediately. I repeat the answer again. The girl sniggered because the teacher shouted at Muthu to go back to his seat immediately. Okay student, let us see the section 2. This section gives the clear view of the scenes outside the train. The scene outside was beautiful with purple blue mountains forming a lovely backdrop to the green fields and estates. Monkeys with babies clinging. Clinging means what? Attached closely to the body onto them. Them were racing all along the tracks. One of the monkeys tried to snatch. Snatch means quickly seize in a rude or eager way. Snatch a banana from a girl as she leaned out of the window. Leaned means saindhu paathal. Leaned out of the window to look at the train curving on the track. She gave a scream. Scream means cry in a high pitched sound and moved back to her seat. Now it was Muthu's turn to snigger at Fatima. Snigger means laughed in a half suppressed way. Merlin looked entranced at the misty clouds. Entranced means filled with wonder and delight, holding their entire attention. Entranced at the misty clouds which covered the mountain, the bubbling stream with a small waterfall and the pretty blue birds were marvelous to see. Suddenly the train stopped with a thud. Thud means a very dull sound as that of a heavy object striking on a solid surface. Boys were so excited to see what had happened. So they begged their teacher to allow them to step out of the train in the end. The whole compartment stepped out and the sight greeted their eyes. Let us see the question part for section 2. First one, describe the beauty of the blue mountain. The answer is the purple blue mountains formed a lovely backdrop to the green fields and tea estates. I repeat answer. The purple blue mountains formed a lovely backdrop to the green fields and tea estates. Second one, why did the girl scream? Scream means cry in a high pitched sound. Your answer is, one of the monkeys tried to snatch a banana from a girl's hand while she was leaning out of the window. She screamed and moved back. I repeat the answer. One of the monkeys tried to snatch a banana from a girl's hand while she was leaning out of the window. She screamed and moved back. Third question, why did Muthu and his friends stepped out of the train? Your answer is, the train stopped suddenly. So Muthu and his friends stepped out of the train to see what had happened. I repeat the answer. The train stopped suddenly. So Muthu and his friends stepped out of the train to see what had happened. Let us see section 3. This section narrates the incident on the track. A cute baby elephant was sitting on the track. The mother elephant was nearby trumpeting. Trumpeting means making a high sound loudly. The engine driver and others tried to coax. Coax means gently to do something. The baby elephant off the train with a bunch of bananas. So they were making all kinds of sound to make the baby elephant move from the track. Just then Muthu went up to the baby with a bunch of bananas. As Muthu stepped back, the baby elephant also moved to eat the banana. Muthu kept doing this until the baby elephant was out of the track. Everyone cheered as the baby and mother elephant started eating the bananas. As they were eating the bananas, everyone got into the train and it left after a delay of an hour. With this, Merlin ended her letter saying that she had a fantastic trip. Fantastic means attractive. She had a fantastic trip and the whole group enjoyed, was so excited by the trip. Let us see the question for section 3. First one, what made the trip a memorable one? Your answer is, on a normal fast train ride, we do not notice the scenery or the landscape. It rushes by so fast. But the train making a slow move up and down the beautiful mountain was different. They were able to enjoy everything thoroughly. I repeat the answer. On a normal fast train ride, we do not notice the scenery or the landscape. It rushes by so fast, but the train making a slow move up and down the beautiful mountain was different. They were able to enjoy everything thoroughly. Second question, what does the phrase presence of mind mean? Explain the phrase using Muthu's action. Your answer is, Muthu had the presence of mind at the right moment. He moved the bunch of bananas backwards whenever the baby elephant moved forward to eat it. He kept doing that till the baby was out on the side of tracks. Everyone cheered this as he had acted correctly at the right time. I repeat the answer. Muthu had the presence of mind at the right moment. He moved the bunch of bananas backwards whenever the baby elephant moved forward to eat it. He kept it doing that till the baby was out on the side of tracks. Everyone cheered this as he acted correctly at the right time. Third question, what is the difference between this toy train and a normal train? Your answer is, the toy train travels through 208 serpentine curves. Serpentine means pambu valaivugal. 16 tunnels. Tunnels means kugaigal. 250 bridges, waterfall hood, cliff edges and tea estates covering a distance of 26 km. It is a showcase of heritage of India. The normal train only takes you to your destination. Destination means end point. Without these beautiful sights. I repeat the answer. The train travels through 208 serpentine curves, 16 tunnels, 250 bridges, waterfall hood, cliff edges and tea estates covering a distance of 26 km. It is a showcase of heritage of India. The normal train only takes you to your destination without these beautiful sights. Let us see the glossary. Glossary means meanings. First one, mesh. Material made of network of wire or thread. Mesh means material made of network of wire or thread. Second one, swaying, moving slowly or rhythmically. Saving, moving slowly or rhythmically. Third one, snaking, moving like a snake. Snaking means moving like a snake. Fourth one, sniggered. Sniggered means laughed in a half suppressed way. Sniggered means laughed in a half suppressed way. Fifth one, clinging. Clinging means fitting closely to the body. Clinging means fitting closely to the body. Sixth one, scream. Scream means cry in a high pitch. Scream means cry in a high pitch. Seventh one, snatch. Quickly seize in a rude or eager way. Snatch means quickly seize in a rude or eager way. Eighth one, entranced. Entranced means filled with wonder and delight, holding their entire attention. Entranced means filled with wonder and delight, holding their entire attention. Ninth one, thud. Thud means a dull sound as that of a heavy object striking a solid surface. Thud means a dull sound as that of a heavy object striking a solid surface. Tenth one, trumpeting. Trumpeting means making a loud noise. 11th one, chugging. Chugging means move slowly, making regular muffled sounds as of an engine running slowly. Chugging means move slowly, making regular muffled sounds as of an engine running slowly. 12th one, coax. Coax means persuade gently to do something. Coax means persuade gently to do something. 13th one, murmur. Murmur means to make a low, continuous, indistinct sound. Murmur means to make a low, continuous, indistinct sound. If you have visited Ooty or some other hill station area, you can also write a letter to your friend about your wonderful experience. I hope you have understood the lesson. Finish your assignment and send it to my WhatsApp. We will meet in the next class. Bye, students.